stacked five heads deep on fold-out tables and chairs, streaming 12 hours a day. You finish your stream, you get off, you upload a YouTube video, go to sleep, you wake up, you do it again. Every fucking day. Every day.
I will not have the college experience because I'm going for my dream.
I want to see death to some flowers. We're not even hitting chest.
Flex the titties, please. We're not hitting chest.
Anyway.
Taking risks in life, it's essential. Not even just calculated risks, just risks. Normally with a risk, you're going to have to push out of your comfort zone quite a bit. Senior year of high school, I went out on a whim and applied to Arizona State University. Hey, out west, I know for one, I enjoy warm weather. I'm originally from Wisconsin and despise the cold after 18 years of living in it. Don't get me wrong, there was those vibes of you just all bundled up in your car. You can see everyone's cold breath waiting outside during high school. Okay, I'm getting ahead of myself. I don't know what it is, but I'm just gonna keep it 100. Out west, everyone here is just attractive, so I was intrigued for the girls. My last reason was to get away from my parents. I could not ask for better parents on both sides, but I wanted to feel true independence. If you can cough on a mirror, you can get into ASU, but I got a scholarship, and here we are now in my sophomore year at ASU. ASU is one of, if not the biggest party school in the country, and you have a kid who had been an introvert at his core his whole life so far, and throughout high school, my main hobby was gaming. I sucked at sports, and that is what I was good at. Then I got into lifting roughly sophomore year, and that's when I took it seriously. I was obsessed with teenage romance in high school, and I'm totally still not obsessed with it right now. I never drank, smoked, and I didn't really party that often in high school. Jumped to ASU, a school plagued by Greek life, a community that emphasizes fake validation from others, partying slash hookup culture, and therefore it has manifested a fantasy for young kids in their 20s. To be clear, this is just my personal opinion. I don't believe every sorority or frat is horrendous. Hell, there is even a lifting frat here. But from my experience, I've seen how much it just consumes people, and then it's their identity. I chose the major film, as you can't major in YouTube or Twitch. So throughout our major, we are getting taught how to get into the movie business and how to create movies. That's not how you become a fucking YouTuber. Ah, and yes, out-of-state tuition. The housing prices out here are similar to LA. With all of that being said of ASU, I love it here. I think deep down it's Arizona mainly. I don't know if ASU is the fit. The definition of taking risks for me is pushing out of your comfort box. And your comfort box could be a million different things. Chat, my comfort box is live streaming or not streaming, just playing the video games and going to the gym and just eating the bare minimum. Truthfully, that's it. I would be comfortable with that life.
You know, fun size.
This one is fun size.
Yeah. They're coming out with a new flavor. New raspberry. Chris Bumstead Asterisk.
But that does not mean I would be satisfied at all. Going to a location that is severely out of my comfort zone pushes me every day. It's a risk. And oftentimes we think of risks at a large level, but you can take minuscule risks every single day. Hitting an old friend up, finally starting that hobby you said you would, working on your dream. This is where it comes full circle. Try at the risk, chat, no matter what it may be, especially if that risk involves pushing for your dream. It doesn't need to make sense either. Speaking in regards to the risk, let me explain.
God, what the fuck?
Oh, I'm sorry. That's a lot.
What are you gonna do about it?
I can wipe it. Wipe it. It's gonna be more wet.
It's fine. The wetter, the better.
ASU being my prime example, it makes zero sense why I went here. Majority of my friends in high school were questioning me, not to mention my YouTube channel. It does not make sense. I now recently set out my goal to be the best fitness slash gaming creator. There is really no creator that does both well. I have such a wide variety of videos on this channel that if someone tuned in who had never watched me before and picked a video, depending on what they pick, they would think it's a different YouTuber each time.
You look so good on camera, daddy.
I don't beat my
meat. Right. Yeah, you don't beat your meat.
Shut the fuck up.
The risk doesn't have to make sense. The risk that you are trying to do, as long as you are pushing out of your comfort zone, you are then succeeding. Trying and trying and trying over again. Put in the sacrifices. Parts of your life will have to be cut out because you are risking something else. I will not have the college experience because I'm going for my dream. Damn, that sucks. Remember when I talked about the comfort box a couple minutes ago? We all get put into boxes whether we like it or not because of society's standards.
Maybe you are too emotional.
Go to a uni, get a job, have a wife or husband, have kids, go out and party, man, have some fun. That is the opposite of risk. That is the opposite of pushing out of your comfort zone for a lot of people. Some people, it really does fit. But if you have a dream, goal, or aspiration, something that I guess would be abnormal, then go for it. And even if that involves something a part of the standard that, yes, I just created, why not be the best at it? That you're going to law school, then become the best lawyer, be the next Saul Goodman. We are getting on a tangent. Enjoy the video, boys. Take the risk, chat. If you're going out of your comfort zone, then it's probably going to benefit you. Lately, it sounds dumb, but man, Nike's slogan has just been reminiscing with me, and I think it fits this video tangent very well. Just do it.
Go, gang. What up, Maverick?
You look like, what's the character in GTA?
I look fucking massive. Thank you. Dirty ass mirror. I'm not looking to get laid. I'm looking for self-improvement, bruh. We're off to Trader Joe's. Well, how could I forget? I'm the Unabomber.
Is it you, Unabomber, the OKC shit?
OKC.
Okay.
Yeah, I believe so. He like hated society. He lived in a cabin in the woods and just created bombs all day.
Like 20 kids.
I think so. I don't know. I thought it was like small bombings all across the country.
Small bomb. Park next to walls and shit.
Wait, pull that back up. You're listening to Linium now? Wow, it just took a girl to change that. That's fucking bullshit. That is wild. Now he listens to Linium. Crazy. Crazy world we live in. Poggers.
Lavender's a flavor?
Yes, lavender. Oh, speaking of that, I need oatmeal.
I'm scared of filming, that's crazy. I was scared. I could feel the organic coursing through my veins. Thank you, sir. No wonder you pulls bitches. Chat!
I have managed to semi-pull. Very respectable female.
Okay. My apologies.
Anyway, what are we listening to?
No. That was like a 6, 7.
That's crazy that you're just reading her.
I wasn't.
I just looked up. I saw movement, so I looked, but.
Oh, okay.
Hey, it's okay.
All good.
We could just reduce her entire life to a set of numbers.
I mean, it is that simple. I respect women.
Look
good.
Sub Twitch.
Stop. You're not so happy. Sunflowers for his shoddy. Yeah, look at this is a haul. I'm hoping that doesn't taste like ass. You got a candle, body butter, citrus body wash. Recommended by sexy, handsome man.
Like, it's absolutely fucking horrible.
Well, that's pretty fire. I want to see death to sunflowers.
Well, whatever happens, happens. I think that I've been dead since the start. I haven't said too much inside my heart, but I don't even care no more. I'm gonna dance till I end up on the floor. Yeah, lullaby. Lullaby. Lullaby.
Yeah, the Velveeta is definitely a little bit dirtier, but I don't care, man. It tastes good. It's okay to not eat clean 24/7. Yeah, it's gonna be a lot of fun to clean. I love dishes. Yes, yes, yes. Damn. Yeah, I'm tapping out. I do this pretty frequently. I'll leave like half or a quarter or however much that may be left of my meal, and then I'll finish it later. So that's what I do. I'll track it now and then I'll finish it later. And I normally always do that. I'm aiming for like 3,500 every day. I'm hitting between 3,000 to 4,000, some even higher. I think one day I hit 5,200, but I was carving up and being a bad boy. So I'm gonna be honest, don't buy the sweet Italian sausage. That kind of tasted like shit. If you just did turkey with this, it would have tasted a bit better, and maybe some Italian some form of seasoning. Anyways, we're going to Muscle Factory now. I'm excited about going to this gym. I know some influencers have gone here, such as Gabe Duchette. I'm excited to go. It looks really sick, and I'll see you guys there. Peace. I'll see you on the tripod. I'll make the transition. I'm sorry. I'll make it right now. Just make the transition jar.
Can you flex them?
We're not even hitting chest.
Flex the titties, please. Chest.
I want to feel it more.
What? Feel what?
The, like, I can keep going and then it just hits a wall.
Yeah.
It's like a wall.
Yeah. For
don't
four rounds.
I can tell, like, when the reps are getting slower, but, like, here, you just reps just stop.
That's how it is. And if your forearms give out, your biceps don't work properly.
It's not.
Like,
I'm flexing, like,
It's just like
from your back or something.
My muscle is not there for my forearm.
Okay.
You had a choice. Why didn't you choose me?
Even if it meant forsaking your aunt.
Yes, it should be.
It feels dense. It feels like I'm lifting Thor's hammer.
You got this.
Damn, this was a big motherfucker.
It should be here now.
Even if it meant hurting her.
If it had to be done.
Even if it meant killing her.
Whatever it takes.
Did you win?
No.
Actually not that great. Your traps are so out, put them in.
Sorry.
Don't apologize.
I like to come out and play. Just drop set everything, dude. Get fired, drop set. Get heartbroken, drop set.
What's the answer?
To pay rent, drop set.
Flex, flex time. Hey.
Damn, the setup looking like I want to kill someone.
Hey, if you made it this far, you are a legend. I hope you enjoyed the video. And I'm doing another announcement. And I know I didn't put it in the title, and I'm probably going to get flamed for this, but I'm going to do one stream a week now. Just seeing from how much time this took me to create this video, I got to have as much time as I need, you know. I still don't even have a job yet. And once that gets into play, time management's going to get crunched even more, a lot more. Hi, I'm back again. I just wanted to say a huge shout out to Anu. This video would not have been possible without him. Some amazing shots were taken by him, as you can see. And he did better than the film major, you know, the person that's going to school for it. But just thank you once again. Big shout out to Anu. I also wanted to preface A New Kind of Love, the song I chose. I know Lex Little did a video recently with it in. I did think about putting this in even before watching that video. I just wanted to state that if it looked like I was copying this song, this is what I'm talking about. But I hope you guys really enjoyed the video. I want to get Sunday upload time reasonably lower than this. I still wanted to, of course, get the video out on Sunday, but I want to choose like a better time other than close to midnight. Appreciate every single one of you. Keep grinding, boys. Later.